Hello guys and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video I'll be showing you that how to configure MongoDB database using mongodb.com. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. First up, I'll go to mongodb.com and then click start pre. Now enter your first name, last name, company, email address and password, and then check the box next to I agree terms and conditions, and then create your Atlas account. If you don't have any company, then you can put your name in the company as well. Now once you create your account, you will receive verification email in your inbox. So click on that email. After you verify your email address, it will show you this screen. Now click on remind me later. Now your account is created successfully. Now we need to create a new cluster. Click create. Now enter your cluster name. It can be anything. After that, select the M0 plane, which is free, and it will give you more than enough space to test. Now select any of the three provider, select region of your choice, click create deployment. Once your deployment is created, you will see this screen. Here put username. In the password field, you can put password of your choice, or it will generate a strong password for you. After that, click create. Now here select drivers. Now check the box, I have installed my driver. Now on the right side, you can see your database URI. You can copy that and use it in your project. Click the close button at the bottom right. Go to network access. Click add IP address. Enter 0.0.0 and then confirm. By putting that address, it's mean that you are allowing access from anywhere. For testing purpose, it's okay to put this address. But for production, you will be using your backend service IP address here. Now click delete and you are able to delete your public IP address. Now click database. Click browse collections. Now you will find the database simple mplex. Delete that as we don't need that. Now click add my own data. Now here you can enter database name, and here you can add your collection name. Click create, and your database is created successfully, as well as your collection name is created successfully. That's all for this video, and in the next video we'll be using Python and MongoDB database.